Hi everyone, it's really good for you to see me once again, and I'd say see you, but obviously I can't see you through the screen, so you know, it's good for you to see me. In this space just now, we're going to be thinking about thankfulness, you know, that idea of being thankful for seeing me. Now, if I'd come out and been ready to film this yesterday, that sky would have been blue. And my coat would have been in the car, my jumper would have been at home, and I'd have been wearing my t-shirt. As it is, it's a bit of a miserable day. And so I've brought you on my walk, but there's plenty to moan about. I wonder, what sort of things could we moan about if we wanted to? The weather? The rain, the dog poo, the pot noodle box, the state of the world, the things that are going on in the news, COVID, school, home, whatever it is, there's plenty to moan about. I don't want to pretend, actually, that there aren't things in this world that we could moan about. You know, sometimes it's good to have a moan, because when we moan about things, it shows that we care. It shows that we want things to get better. But I want to remind you today that it's not all about moaning. I want to remind you of something that's a bit more difficult to do. That we're to be thankful people. You know, I wrote my list about pot noodle boxes and dog poo and COVID, but I wonder how easy it would be to write a list of things that I'm thankful for on my walk. You know, maybe I could start with the fact that I can walk and I can be outside and that it's not raining so heavily, you know, that I'm drenched through to the skin. I could be thankful for the colours, for the leaves, for nature, for the animals that I've seen on my walk. But I wonder, what would be on my list for all the other days? What would be on my list in general of things to be thankful for? What would be on your list? At this point, you could perhaps pause the video and start writing a list or thinking about a list for yourself. Or maybe it's just something that you could do later on. But what are you thankful for?
So, let's be real. Some days are hard. So I made this list of awesome things I'm thankful for. Yeah. Sometimes I need reminding that things are not all that bad. So I wanted to share a few, because you guys are my friends. It's great to be alive. And here's some reminders why. First one, bubble wrap. When cats do their tongue, like this. I'm also thankful for the little paw pads that the cats and dogs have and the sound it makes. Oh, I love them. Hey, turn that back on. Oh, no. Change it. Ah, there, that's better. Music is magical. It can make anything better. Right, music can make a video better. The same goes with life. Singing. I like pop hats. Singing. If something's boring, just sing it, and that will make it better. Watching paint dry. It's really cool. Old people who still hold hands. Clouds that look like stuff. One time I saw a cloud that looked like an airplane, and I realized it was an airplane. Imagination. Without it, we wouldn't have airplanes, no internet. Pants. We gotta wear them, because if we didn't, it'd be sort of awkward. Pants. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Sleep. Clothes with funny names. Like windbreaker. Birthday cake. No reason at all cake. Just cake. Sorry if we filmed this while I was hungry. Forgiveness. I'm Kid President, but I ain't perfect. ain't a word. We all mess up, come on. Don't mess up and forget to forgive all the mess ups. Thankful plants undergo photosynthesis, using the energy from the sun to convert carbon dioxide to oxygen, providing us with the air we need to do things like this.
I'm bored.
Morgan Freeman's voice. Hello, I'm Morgan Freeman. I'm working on it. My voice is changing, but it hasn't changed that much.
Food, taco,
burger. I know, I already said food, but this is my list and my rules.
Happiness.
Sadness. Sad isn't bad. It helps you know what you care about. People. Sometimes people can be really people-y, but we need each other. Life's better with people in it. Family, friends.
You.
Just being alive. Sometimes we forget how it's just great to be alive. We're breathing. Some days are tough, but we got a lot to be thankful for. We just have to look for it sometimes. They say if you have food in your fridge, clothes on your back, and a place to sleep, you're richer than 75% of the world.
I did not know that.
So what would you add to the list? Let me know. Share this video with someone you're really thankful for. Oh, and of course, also this. Dancing!
So I don't know how easy you did or will find making your list of things to be thankful for. Sometimes it can be a bit difficult. And it's at those times where we find ourselves moaning more than we're saying thank you, or more than we're grateful for the things around us, that we need to grow what I want to call, and I'm not the first person to call it this because it's been called it for a long time, an attitude of gratitude. We need to make choices in ourselves about the way that we look at things. And that as we look at them, instead of seeing the negative things or the things that bring us down or the things that we like to moan about, I wonder whether we can be a bit more intentional about finding the things to be thankful for. I wonder, what things might we notice if we chose to be more thankful about things at school? Or at home, or at work, or if we chose to look at things in such a way where we saw the world around us as a more positive place, as something we wanted to help get even better rather than just help it to get good in the first place. Whether we could seize the opportunities that we have, that even when things are bad, there might be chances to try or to do new things and to be thankful for the chance. I wonder what it would look like if we chose to be more thankful for the people around us, if we noticed what they did for us. And I wonder what it looked like if we were more thankful for who we are as well. As a Christian, I quite like the Bible. I think it has lots that it can teach me about God and about the world and about myself. And in the Bible, in the New Testament, right near the end, there's a book called the Book of James. And in the Book of James, chapter 1, verse 17, it says that every good and perfect gift comes from God above. All those things that you have been able to think of, or that you will be able to think of, all those things that Kid President was able to think of, all those things that I'm hoping to notice, for me, if they're good, they come from God. And so when I'm thankful, I'm saying thank you to God. Now, it might be that you don't believe there is a God, and that's your choice, and that's fine. But I wonder who you are thankful to. I wonder, as you go through life, for the things at home, who could you say thank you to, or how could you show that you're thankful? The things at school, who is it who helps you? And how can you show that you're thankful? At the end of that video we watched, Kid President suggested that we should share our list of things to be thankful for with somebody that we're thankful for. And that's why I shared it with you. You see, I'm not just thankful for the things around me. I'm also thankful for you. And I think that you are actually a pretty good thing. I think that you are a gift. And it's right to be thankful for you being unique and individual, and for everything that you bring to the world. And so thank you for being here. And again, as a Christian, I believe that we're here and that we're unique because God made us that way. That God made us special. And in the book of Psalms, right in the middle, it says, I thank you because you made me wonderful. I thank you for everything that you have done to make me who I am. Now, sometimes it's easier for us to think about the good things in the world or the good things that we see in other people, and we forget to see the good things in ourselves. You know, at the moment I could focus on the fact that I'm out of breath because I'm unfit, because I haven't done enough walking. Or I could focus on these grey hairs that keep appearing more and more. Or on my wonky teeth. Or the fact I have to wear glasses. Or the fact I keep making mistakes and I'm not very good. But what God says, and what I believe, is that you are special. And that it's worth saying thank you for who you are. And being grateful that you are you. Because I believe that each and every one of you has something to offer in this world. I wonder, when you look at the world, what are you going to choose to be thankful for? I wonder, when you look at your friends and your community, what are you going to be thankful for? And I wonder, if we choose to look at ourselves with an attitude of gratitude, what could we be thankful for about ourselves? Take care, and I'll see you soon.
And trees, puppy dogs. music and my nose. Pandas and nostrils and trees.
Pandas and nostrils and trees?
A great God of all things bright and a great God of all things beautiful. A great God of all things wild and free, free. Thank you, God, for making me.
Nostrils and trees and other stuff.
How about frogs and crazy crocodiles?